All right, welcome to Power Hour on Monday, January 18th, 2021. All right, for time and date stamp. So we'll start with, I'm gonna draw a card, see what we got here. Forgiveness. Okay, so this is, set this attention, just be forgiveness. So here's the declaration. I can't change the past. I can only change my present. I know that by forgiving others and myself for any past hurts, I allow myself to be free and at ease. So that's good. I feel like for many of us, it's easier to forgive others than ourselves. So that's just my two cents. So I'm not going to do the breathing and all that, but let's start with, so forgiveness is our attention tonight. And that includes ourselves, which I think is something many people struggle with at times. So anyway, we're going to start with A to Z. So for those that know what you're doing, which is everybody I see here, carry on. I'll go through it. So if you're new and on the recording, what we're going to do is we're going to pull up our Facebook app. Ideally, you want to come to this with two devices, one being the phone that you're going to work on if you can, and then the other being either a desktop, laptop, or even an iPad that your Zoom is on, so that we can, and we want to work through the Facebook app because that puts our friends list in alphabetical order. So I'll show you how to do that. So there's a Facebook app on my phone. Open it, and it takes you right to the top. So I'm going to click on my little picture there on that right. Well, it's my left when I'm looking at it. So click on that. And it takes me to my wall. And then I'm going to scroll down to my friends. And at the bottom of that, it says, see all friends. That was hard to see. There we go. See all friends. Touch that. And that puts all your friends list in alphabetical order. So if you're brand new, you're going to start at the very tippy top there. For me, it would be A. Bruce Mahan. And so that's where we're going to start. Hi, Renee.
Hi.
So I would click on Bruce's photo. And Bruce has not updated his picture in a while. So I would touch his profile picture. And I could see that it's blue. So that means I've commented on it already. So then I would go to his cover photo and comment on that beautiful picture, and then click it, like it, and then it's blue. So that's how I know that I've already, so when I come back through my A to Z, I'll know that I've already commented on both his profile and his cover photo. So when we're A to Z commenting, we're saving these two pictures, first the profile and then the cover photo for A to Z. So that's, we really want to save those for A to Z commenting. When we say A to Z, so I've already commented on Bruce, I'm going to go back and click on the next one, AJ Melvin. And we are literally going systematically one after the other, right down our friends list. And when we're done at the end of our A to Z commenting, we're going to either take a screenshot, save it into files, whatever method we choose to save whatever method we choose to save our where we left off at. So, and that's kind of where we're at. So I'm going to go ahead and work as well. If anyone has any friend or questions, comments, something you'd like to share, feel free to come off.
I want to add something to the forgiveness.
Yeah.
I learned at a seminar. Some people don't understand the whole concept of that. What I learned that I didn't understand before was forgiving doesn't mean saying that what the other person did was okay. It just means that you're forgiving them for what they did. So the example they used was pretty cool. Actually, the lady was saying, okay, so if I sit down beside, let's just say Sue, and she pulls a chair out from under me and I fall on the floor, okay, that doesn't mean if I forgive her, that doesn't mean that what she did was okay. right?
Right.
But I'm going to forgive her. But then the next time she invites me to sit beside her, I'm going to be very cautious around her. So you have to, you know, there's a little bit more to it than just saying I forgive you and that's it, the end of it. But and also that, like, if holding a grudge against someone and not forgiving them is like taking poison and waiting for the other person to get the results of the poison. So it's for you.
Right.
Them. Yes.
Thank you. That's true though, you're right. Renee, our thing was forgiveness. That's why we're talking about that. So it says, I can't change the past. I can only change my present. I know that by forgiving others and myself, I don't know, for some reason, and myself jumped out at me today. For any past hurts, I allow myself to be free and at ease. So that's kind of what we're talking about. And in my opinion, it feels like many people have the hardest time forgiving themselves. Like, you can forgive others, but oftentimes you don't forgive yourself as easily and quickly. And I don't know, it just feels like shackles. When you hold a grudge and you don't give people grace or yourself grace, it just feels like you're just shackled by the past. So anyway, I'll get off my high horse there, but I've got some things to say about that.
All right, I got one more thing, then I'm done.
Are you sure? I'm kidding.
Well, I don't know. We're going to be on here for a while.
Right, we got a whole hour. Mom's on a roll. Anyway, go ahead.
You don't always have to tell that person that you forgave them. You can just forgive them in your heart, you know.
Right.
But sometimes you do need to tell them.
And sometimes forgive them, and that doesn't mean I want to hang around you all the time either, right? I mean, you can forgive somebody for whatever was done in the past, real or imagined, even sometimes, I feel like. And then you don't have to be BFFs. You can just forgive and then just kind of have your distance. It's fine. Again, just my opinion.
wanted to talk about the pictures, profile pictures.
Mm-hmm.
I never noticed before, like I clicked on a profile picture. If you slide to the left, you can get all the other profile pictures. Mm. I never noticed that before.
I didn't either. I've always gone through albums. I go through albums.
Yeah. I don't, maybe it's something new, but
yeah, I never just noticed did it either. Tonight. It's a good tip. Go ahead, Renee. You got something? So if you've already commented on that one, for example, I was just working here. When you said that, I was on there, and I've already commented. You just swipe it, and there's a new, the most recent before that, the current one.
Yeah, maybe that's the new upgrade or something. I never noticed.
Oh, no, that's cool, though. I never knew it either. Thank you for sharing that. Also, that same thing works with the cover photo, which I guess would make sense. But just swiping it, if you've already commented on it, you see their most recent cover photo before the one that's current.
I found out you can go either, on some of them, you can go left or right.
Oh, really?
Yeah, maybe, I don't know why, but some right. could, some.
I don't know why. Can you guys read that? It says how to jumpstart a millennial. He's got a nose ring. He's getting ready to put a battery in his nose. That's funny. I literally LOL'd. Okay, go ahead. I want to take like a few minute break, pause the recording. We're not going to do A to Z when we get back. So if you want to say where you're at, that'd be awesome. Okay, so we'll go do friend requests, and you guys probably already doing it. So if you're watching the recording, what I've been doing lately, once I found out you can do this, is actually pretty cool, is going to recent friends and friend requesting, and it Facebook gives you suggestions. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So again, we're going to go through our Facebook app and then click on your little picture there. Right there. We're going to go back to this kind of the same spot we were at. And it takes you to your wall. I call it your wall. I don't know. There's probably another name for it too. And then you're going to go scroll down to where it says see all friends. Click on that. And you'll see at the very top there. I hope you can see it here. I'll see it sometimes. I'm struggling here. Riding the struggle bus. There we go. All friends and then recent. So click on recent and it will tell you your most recent friends. And then from there you can go in. So the most recent's on top. And then go in. I'm going to go into hers. And if her friends list isn't protected, which it's not, because I could tell by looking, we have three mutual and she has 334 friends. So if her friends list was protected, all I could see would be three mutual friends. The fact that I can see that she has 334 friends tells me that it's not protected. So I'm going to click on see all friends. I clicked on her see all friends and then click on suggestions. And then it gives you a bunch of suggestions, 9, 6, 13. So then you'd start there and just kind of go through. I don't just start going add friend, because we may have somebody there, you know, if you don't know these people, you know, or if you get, I don't know, like you just don't get a good feel, or they're not that very active, or we have, you know, other health coaches in common, then I would not friend them. So it takes a little bit going this way, doing it. But I feel like it's more thorough. And I just like doing it. I feel like you're going to reach into different places that you wouldn't normally reach into. Because this girl, for example, we only have three mutual friends. I think she friend requested me, but I'm not sure. But now I can kind of get into, you know, her friends list and just see if there's, you know, what people I may know. Does anyone else ever get lost, forget about what you're doing? Like you go into a friends list, like, what am I doing? Like, I don't even know how far to go back to get right back to where I was, where I started. That just happened to me. All right, so let's just, for the next maybe, not quite 15 minutes, but almost until 8 o'clock, let's just work in some groups we're comfortable working in. Just kind of comment, you know, just bring love to people's pictures. If you have a picture you want to add to yourself or something like that, that's pertinent to that group that's going to add value. Okay, we're getting ready to wrap up in a couple of minutes. So if you haven't already done your before and after, if you want to do that now, you can. So I'm getting ready to do. All right, 8 o'clock. So everyone has a great night. See you guys Wednesday.
Thank you.
Wow, you're welcome.